Welcome to Conversations Live. For more than a decade, we've brought you the best in books, entertainment, and current events. When the movers and shakers of the world have something to say to you, they say it to us first. And now, celebrating 15 years of broadcasting, here's your host, Cyrus Webb.
And welcome back, everyone, to Conversations Live. I'm your host, Cyrus Webb. Glad you all could join us once again, whether you're tuning in on the radio dial here in Mississippi at WYAD 94.1 FM or through WYADonline.com. We're glad you all could join us today. Also, those tuning in through online affiliates around the world, including our iHeartRadio family, we're glad you all could join us as well. I'm really excited to welcome Colin D. McIntosh to our program today. Colin is gearing up for a very big release. That is, of course, the creation of his Sheets and Giggles lines. We're really excited to be able to talk to Colin, not only about the creation of Sheets and Giggles, but also how this all began, what it's been like for him to use new media to help spread the word, and more importantly, how you guys can get 10% off if you pre-order it this month. Colin, hello to you, and welcome to the program.
Hey, Cyrus. Thanks so much for having me.
Hey, the pleasure is definitely all mine. I was just saying to you before we began the segment, Colin, it's a busy time for you, so we really do appreciate this time. I mean, how does it feel to be this close? I mean, you've been able to have this great creation, to be able to start spreading the word about it. How does it feel to now be able to release this out to the world?
Well, you know, it's great. It's one of those things where I look back on the last about 11 months. We incorporated the company in October of last year, and it feels like it's just been a snap of the fingers. I mean, in the last 3 months since we officially launched the company to the public, we've gotten about almost 5,000 pre-orders for our eucalyptus bed sheets. And it's just one of those things where you have an idea, you think it'll resonate with people, and then to see it come to fruition and people, you know, say, yeah, this is actually something that I want in on. Nothing's going to feel better than shipping out those first several thousand units next month.
Right. And I think what's so great for this, and we all have heard that field of dreams adage, Colin, you know, if you build it, they will come. And what you just shared, you know, with the pre-orders, that's definitely happened. And it's grown, right? I mean, you know, again, you know, I mentioned, of course, it's called Sheets and Giggles, but I mean, it's really grown into more than just sheets with pillowcases and other items. Did you know from the very beginning that you wanted it to be something that would be a full-fledged brand?
I think so, yeah. I think that one of the things that struck me early on in the beginning is that I couldn't really find a really strong, sustainable home brand. I mean, there are a lot of home brands when it comes to luxury or basics or, you know, pretty much everything in between. But I couldn't really find one that stuck out where sustainability was at the core of everything they did. And then also a fun brand as well in a traditionally boring space was definitely something that I wanted to build. So home textiles and home goods in general was a really attractive category for me. And, you know, we've got sheets, pillowcases, duvet covers, and comforters now, you know, all made out of eucalyptus. And so that's definitely something that we're going to continue to grow the line as time goes on.
Right. So let's talk about that, about what, you know, what the products are made out of, because that was an interesting thing for me. And for those who have not visited the website, we're going to be giving that out throughout the segment, but it's sheetsgiggles.com. And definitely be careful when you're saying it, especially when you're being able to discuss this like on radio like we are today. But, you know, I think that the great thing is about when you think about eucalyptus, you don't necessarily think about, well, no, I don't. I don't think about sheets. I think about my normally, you know, for myself, because I deal with allergies, I'm normally thinking about my humidifier. But how did you find out about not only the value of eucalyptus, but also how this could be such a great component for your brand?
Well, I was, you know, and by the way, with the name of the company, definitely got to be careful on radio, you know, Sheets and Giggles. can get you in trouble, one slip of the tongue. Basically, I was looking for probably the most sustainable fabric source that I could possibly find when it came to the bed sheets. But at the end of the day, we also wanted something that was extremely comfortable and affordable. And basically, I wasn't going to start the company if I couldn't find a material that hit all three of those things. Because, I mean, you can make something sustainable all day long, and this is, you know, just kind of a comment on humanity. If it's not soft and it's not affordable, they're not going to put it on their bed. And that's totally fair. I mean, I'm not going to sleep on nothing just because it's the most sustainable option. and so eucalyptus, when you turn it into fabric, it's actually called lyocell is the technical name. And it's considered one of the most environmentally friendly processes of fabric production in the world, using up to 96% less water than cotton, up to 30% less energy. And also the trees themselves, a lot of people know that eucalyptus is naturally insecticide, and so they use no pesticides, no insecticides on the trees when they're growing on the plantations. And they're also sustainable and biodiverse plantations as well that we grow our trees on. So we're not natural, we're not harvesting any natural forests or endangered forests or anything like that. So, you know, versus cotton, which is obviously the mainstay in the bed sheets industry, and it's been, I think cotton has been king for centuries now. It's really something that I want to start educating people on is of what a dirty crop cotton is. And I mean, it uses anywhere from 16 to 24% of the world's insecticides just by itself as a crop. And, you know, when people hear that and they understand how much water is used to make one single cotton bed sheet, you know, in the thousands of liters of water for a single cotton bed sheet, and whereas we use in the low hundreds of liters of water for our bed sheets, it's a no-brainer, I think, especially when they feel the fabric for themselves and they realize, oh, it's actually softer than most of the cotton sheets that I've ever touched.
Wow. And I think, you know, it's so great, you know, some of the information you just shared, a column we know because, you know, we, if anyone's been on your website, you know, we've been in bed with you, and you were sharing some of this information on the video that you have that you have on the website there. But also, I think, you know, when people go to the About tab, and I definitely invite people to do that because they're able to not only see you, of course, enjoying the outdoors, it's very obvious from just the information you were sharing, Colin, that it was very important for you to make sure this was something that was not only, of course, good for homes, but also good for the world. I mean, how much has your, you know, your own love of the outdoors, love of the environment, how much has that played a part into what you're doing with Sheets and Giggles?
It's definitely helped. You know, I grew up in South Florida, in Fort Lauderdale, and I was always out on the water, always in the ocean, growing up. And I've lived now in a couple different places, Denver for the last several years. And, you know, Colorado definitely is a place that puts the environment right at the forefront of everything we do. And there's, you know, I don't think that Sheets and Giggles is unique in Colorado from a startup concept. I think that there's a lot of companies in Colorado that put sustainability and environmentally friendly initiatives at the forefront of everything that they're doing. And so that definitely played a big part in the company that I wanted to start. I'm a very mission-oriented kind of guy. At my last company that I was working on for several years prior to starting this, it was basically a 21st century life alert device. And, you know, we definitely saved some lives. And, that was really something that was really important to me. And so moving into my own company, it was something where, I really wanted a mission that would get me out of bed in the morning. And I definitely think that the Colorado environment, having grown up on the water in South Florida and, you know, really, always being an eco-conscious person definitely played into the company.
Gotcha. And now we're able to see that even in this conversation. I want to say for those who are just tuning in, either on the radio side or online, you're listening to Conversations Live. We're excited to welcome Colin D. McIntosh to our program today. He's the CEO and founder of Sheets and Giggles. They're gearing up for a very big launch in September. Right now they're offering 10% off of pre-orders that are done during this month. So you still have a few days left to be able to take advantage of that. We're going to let you guys know how you can find out more information. I mentioned, you know, having fun with this, Colin, and you know, the video that you all did, you know, kind of taking us through, you know, some of the, you know, the benefits of, you know, the sheets that you've been able to create and the products. You know, how much did you know that fun was going to be a part of this? You know, I tell people all the time, I, you know, I'm on the air a lot, I work a lot, but it's a lot of fun for me. I enjoy what I do. How much has that helped you knowing that this is something that you not only enjoy, but it's something you also are passionate about?
You're exactly right. I mean, you got to have fun when you're starting a company. I mean, at least for me, I don't think that I could you know, start a company that was very boring and bland and, you know, very serious tone and that sort of thing. And I think that that's the one of the reasons I was so excited to start Sheets and Giggles was and I laugh every time I say the name. I sometimes just say S&G for short so I don't make myself laugh. But the reason why I started the company with the brand name that I did and the personality that I did behind it was this space is super boring. I mean, if you go on some of our competitors' Instagram pages, I mean, they're all selling the same 300 thread count cotton sheets. They've all got the white room with the white sheets and the supermodel in bed eating, you know, pizza for some reason with full makeup on. And, you know, maybe there's a French press coffee on the bed because that's something that apparently people do is they put French press coffee on the bed. And I think that I looked at the space and I was just so bored out of my mind. And I realized that, you know, with this brand name and with the personality that just, you know, injecting my own sense of fun into the brand every day, You know, making people laugh is a really powerful tool. And I think that especially in this environment, the world's so serious. There's, you know, there's tough news to watch every single day. And I think that people get inundated with bad news. And so we just like to keep it light. And instead of other sustainability brands where they kind of hit you over the head with the world is ending, we're all doomed, which, you know, certainly a good message. We tend to lead with the laughter, and we really want to make you laugh and make you smile and make you feel good. And the sustainability is part of that feel good. And so I think the brand plays in really well with the mission.
Yeah. You mentioned Instagram, so I think that's a great segue back to social media, Colin. you know, I want to ask you about the pressure, because one of the things that you recently posted on Instagram, of course, and even on Twitter, I noticed this as well, is the press that you've been getting for Sheets and Giggles. Are you feeling the pressure of it with the release coming so soon and with people, you know, being excited about what you've been able to create?
Yes, gobs of pressure. But it's all relative. I think that pressure and stress when it comes to starting your own business is a certain type of animal, and it's definitely something that'll keep you up working until 4, 5, 6 in the morning, almost every night, making sure that everything is just so that you're responding to every single customer inquiry, that, you know, you don't leave any stone unturned when it can make the difference between make or break for your company. So, but that's, you know, that's stress that I enjoy in a weird way. And I think that, it's definitely a lot of pressure to deliver, but you're putting that pressure on yourself. And the expectations, from the outside world, you know, one thing that I always stress for my friends and other people that I know that are starting businesses. And that was a great lesson that I learned early on in my career is, you can't believe your own press. And I include this interview in that. I mean, like, obviously it's terrific to be with you here, but when you start believing your own press and you start reading your own press releases and nodding your head and saying, we are great. That's when you start to lose innovation and lose urgency. And so even though it's great to see the outside press and to see, you know, we've been covered in Forbes, we've been covered in Real Simple. We've been covered locally in great publications like, you know, Built in Colorado and Colorado Business Journal. You know, it's really awesome to see that, but you just have to keep it in perspective and, you know, constantly be your own worst critic. And I think that helps manage the stress and expectations, and make sure that you deliver on time and according to expectations.
Yeah. Did you go into this, Colin, knowing that you were in being innovative and thinking outside the box? And as you mentioned, of course, everyone thinks cotton when they think of sheets. And, right. You know, and we should say, too, this is more than just sheets. You're not just buying sheets. I mean, you really are buying the set for your bed, and we're going to be giving that information out more at the end of our segment. But did you know that you were going to be showing other people by example how they could be able to not only to have a dream, but to make that dream a reality?
I think, you know, when in Colorado, we've got this saying, and it's called give first. And it's really something that's been imbued in a lot of companies out here. And I think it's a very collaborative community that we have in Colorado and in Denver and Boulder specifically, where companies tend to give freely to one another, give free advice, mentorship, information, data. It's really terrific. And so, my last company benefited tremendously from that atmosphere, and so now that I'm starting a company of my own, and again have benefited tremendously from other people giving me their advice, their mentorship, their connections, their lessons, I love being able to turn around and do that with both friends and people that I meet for the first time. I'm doing a panel in September for Denver Startup Week, where I'll be on a great panel with four other founders in Colorado, where we talk about bringing a physical product to market and the challenges, how different it is to bring a physical product to market versus a software product to market, which is what a lot of new companies focus on. And so it's just one of those things where I always knew that I'd give back. I don't know if I thought that I would be giving this much advice this fast to a lot of other people, but that also comes with the exposure and you know, the emails pour in for a connection or a question or here and there. And I'm always happy to give as much advice as possible. And also I ask plenty of questions myself.
Well, it's exciting to be able to watch. And I think the great thing, too, is that you're not only being able to provide a quality product, Colin, but also, of course, knowing that you're going to be able to help people along the way, give them something that's going to last. And I think when people think about betting, it's something you do not want to be buying all the time, unless you're doing it for gifts, I guess. I think, a lot of times, you look at that as an investment. So let's talk about exactly what they get, because, I think for regardless of, what size bed you have, talk to them about what they get. And again, for those who have not been to the website, again, it's sheetsgiggles.com, and we'll be posting this for our online audience so you guys can just click on it from there. But it's more than just sheets. What exactly comes in the set that they get, Colin?
Yeah, and in terms of the searchability of the product as well and the brand, if you just search for Sheets and Giggles on Google, we're the first result. So if that's easier than remembering the URL, Sheets and Giggles, pretty unique name. There's nobody else popping up there. So in terms of what they get with the product, we've got four main products that we've come out with. So number one is a sheet set. And so that's just very typical, two pillowcases, a flat sheet, and a fitted sheet. On top of the sort of, obvious nature of what you get in it, we also have extra deep corners for our sheets, so that way they fit on mattresses up to 20 inches thick, because there's nothing in the world more frustrating than trying to get that last corner on your bed when the fitted sheet just won't fit on it. With the exception of maybe the fitted sheet, removing itself from your corners in the middle of the night on your bed, that's the worst. Aside from the sustainability aspect of the eucalyptus and the softness of the sheets themselves, we also built in a lot of features like that 20-inch thick fitted sheet, the elastic that goes all the way around. We've got a little tag on the corner of the fitted sheet to let you know which corner to put on first, because that's also a huge frustration personally of mine. And then in terms of the other three products, we've got extra pillowcases, which people love to buy. I don't know anybody that just has two pillows on their bed. And then we also have duvet covers, which if you have an existing duvet or an existing comforter, it's a great way to get that eucalyptus feel, that smoothness and softness on top of you at night without having to invest in a whole new duvet or comforter. You just pop your existing one right into that duvet cover. And then we also do have a eucalyptus comforter for people that want something that they can use without a duvet cover or with a duvet cover. It fits into our covers. And it's, the thing about eucalyptus, I think, surprises a lot of people, is that it actually has higher smoothness ratings than cotton sheets. And it's also naturally more breathable and more moisture wicking. And so I'm a hot sleeper, and I'm also from South Florida, so I understand sweating at night. Nobody's business. And these are the most breathable, most moisture-wicking sheets that I've ever used, and I've never felt cooler at night than when I'm sleeping on my own set of Sheets and Giggles bed sheets. And I love that I can say that without feeling like I'm selling anything, because they're just legitimately the best sheets that I've ever personally owned.
Yeah, and that says a whole lot. That says a lot. And we definitely, I think the other side of this, too, that's so exciting for me that I love, that, the attention to detail. And also, I think, wanting people to know. You've done something I do not see a lot of businesses that I talk to on this program, Colin, do, and that is to leave Easter eggs throughout your site. I'm one of these big nerds that reads everything. I mean, everything.
That's good. No, those are the people that we're putting those Easter eggs in for. And you're it's funny, you mentioned that, and I wouldn't say that you're spoiling the surprise, but yes, if you look on our website carefully in certain places, maybe you hover over something or you view one of the pictures that's just a random picture, you'll see that we've got little Easter eggs on our site where if you take a screenshot of that and you email it into us, we actually upgrade your order with a free extra gift in there. I don't want to spoil what the extra gift is, but it's also made out of our eucalyptus fabric, and it's something that'll help you sleep at night. So I think that people can infer guess what it is from there. But that's actually been one of the best things that we've done. It's so much fun. People will email us and they'll say, "I found your Easter egg. I'm so proud of myself. I hunted for all of them on the page and I found all three." And I love personally emailing those people back and just saying great eyes and, thanks so much for your order. And it's really a personal interaction. And I think it's just one of those smaller things that can brighten somebody's day.
Well, I think, you know, the big thing that's going to be the big seller for you guys, Colin, and I think it's already coming through in the comments I saw even on Facebook, the customer service, that interaction, like you mentioned with the emails, that is going to be, I think, what really sets you guys apart. Unfortunately, good customer service is not always a given. So I think for people to be able to get that when it comes to something like this is going to mean a whole lot. Again, everyone, Colin D. McIntosh has been our guest. Great conversation with you, Colin. We've been talking with him not only about what it's been like for him as the CEO and founder of Sheets and Giggles, or S&G, as you heard him mention, but also now what it's been like for him to gear up for the big release that's coming up. Now, as I mentioned, if you're joining us, of course, live and listening to us in August, you guys can qualify for 10% off in September. I noticed on the site, Colin, they get 5% off of their order there. Is the website the best? Is that kind of the hub for you guys, sheetsgiggles.com? And as you mentioned, if they Google, is that kind of the best place for them to go to get the information and to find out more information about the product?
That's the best place to go, yeah. If you just search on Google for Sheets and Giggles, you'll find us. We're the first result. And, you know, sheetsgiggles.com is the URL. It can trip people up because there's no and in the URL. So I just say just Google Sheets and Giggles. But yeah, we're right now in August. You know, we've got about 2 weeks left in August now. If you order on our website, you'll get 10% off. Because it is a pre-order and you do have to wait, you know, a month or a month and a half or so for your sheets, we're happy to give that 10% off for people that want to pre-order now and receive them next month. It's really great to see the adoption that we're getting right now. I mean, people are sharing it via word of mouth. I mean, you mentioned our customer service earlier. There's nothing more fun to me than going on Facebook and replying to people's comments and making jokes with them. And I think that if you start like a funny company, Sheets and Giggles, it attracts funny people. We had somebody yesterday say, "I love the product, but I hate the name." And I think our response was just, "Well, you're entitled to your opinion, but you're wrong." It's definitely a lot of fun to see all the fun people that comment. And then occasionally you get somebody that's a bit of a curmudgeon. But if they can't laugh at a funny name for a company, then they're probably not our target audience anyway.
Exactly. And hey, I bet they probably won't forget it. And I think that's the thing, right?
Exactly. Yeah.
So again, everyone, Colin McIntosh has been our guest. Great conversation with you, Colin. Thank you so much for being on with us. And looking forward to having you back on the program again.
Oh, I would love to join you anytime, Cyrus. It's been really terrific. And, just thanks so much for having me and for introducing people to Sheets and Giggles.
Glad to do it. And we thank your audience for tuning in to another great segment of Conversations Live.